Hello, this is Neal Lipschutz. We're in Davos, Switzerland at the annual meeting of the World Economic Forum. I'm joined by Robert Greifeld. He's the Chief Executive Officer of NASDAQ.
Glad to be here.
Thank you very much. First question, there's obviously been a big planned and announced merger between the NYSE and the ICE. What impact do you see that having for NASDAQ and the competitive exchange landscape?
Well, I think it's probably a good deal in that NYSE was running into difficulty getting their London clearinghouse together. ICE has demonstrated capability in that regard. But from our point of view, it really doesn't have any direct impact. We compete quite aggressively with NYSE. We think that will continue post the acquisition. We don't compete with ICE today. We think that will continue post the acquisition. So it'll be more of the same.
And how about plans going in 2013, just started? How about plans for NASDAQ this year? What do you see? What sort of growth ideas? What sort of plans do you have?
Well, we had a very strong 2012. So our diversification strategy has worked very well. And when you see our performance so far in 2012, it's very strong and incredibly strong relative to the volume decline. So to the extent we keep executing our plan, we're doing very well. We announced the acquisition of the Thomson Reuters IR suite of products. We expect that to close in the second quarter of 2013.
Is that a direction for you to go into some of those sort of corporate services?
It has been. We had built in a de novo basis our businesses up to about $100 million a year in revenue. This was, you know, probably triple that business. It will actually be larger than our listing business. And the key point here is we want to have a deep and comprehensive set of relationships with our issuers. So beyond just the issue, you know, the opening bell ceremony, we want to have reasons why we can provide product and services that make it easier for a public company to operate in today's environment.
In 2012, you know, part of the exchange and market scene was a lot of news about some technical glitches. What has NASDAQ done, and what does the industry or the regulatory environment need to do to make that a thing of the past?
Yeah. So we operate, obviously, in a highly competitive, some would say fragmented equity space. And that brings a set of complexities to it. And I think the industry has done very good to test for the positive case, to make the systems work. What you'll see in 2013 and on is more focus on negative testing. What happens if one of our colleagues, competitors in the space doesn't work? Can we handle that? Do we have resiliency and robustness in the system? That has to be the focus.
And you're optimistic that in 2013 we'll see fewer of those?
I am. We're never going to claim to get to a state of perfection, but certainly we believe the attention on this negative testing, and that's really the focus area, will bear fruit.
In the traditional equity exchange markets, getting listings of new IPOs is always an important factor, and as you alluded to, a competitive factor. What's your outlook for the IPO market in 2013, and where do you see, perhaps by industry or geography, the IPOs coming from?
That's a great question. So one, I think you'll see continued strength in technology IPOs. So 2012, the IPO market was relatively stronger than the overall market. We expect that to continue in 2013. We see that really being something of interest to us, and technology will lead. We also see really interest coming from Europe, from Israel, from other parts of the world to come list in the U.S. It's now widely recognized that for technology-based companies, we have the most deep, liquid, fair, and transparent market for these companies.
And is there a worry for you on the regulatory front? Has been an issue and discussed for several years that somehow the regulatory burden would discourage some global companies from listing in the U.S.?
Well, I think what you see is in the Sarbanes-Oxley world, most of the developed markets have in fact copied or implemented things very similar to Sarbanes-Oxley. I think the sticking point with U.S. regulation is what's known as Section 404. We're somewhat unique in that where we require external auditors to verify internal controls. So outside of that, I think our regulatory structures across the developed markets are remarkably similar.
Thank you very much
Thank
for joining
you.
Us.
Appreciate your time.